that he gave his only begotten Son, and that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Many people think that they can get to heaven by good works, but the Bible says we are not saved by works, we are saved by grace. It's God's unmerited love, it's his favor towards us all. Jesus Christ died on the cross of Calvary for your sins and for my sins. Your sins and my sins nailed into the cross of Calvary. We only can get redemption through the blood of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ doesn't just care for you, Jesus Christ loves you. Scarcely would a man lay down his life for a friend, but Jesus loves the whole world that he laid down his life for us. The Bible says that for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. I'm encouraging all of those who are going on from work. I pray in the name of Jesus that you'll take thought on where you're heading. The Bible says it's appointed unto men once to die, but comes the judgment. Hell is real, heaven is also real. And Jesus Christ says that it's not his desire that any one of us should perish, but that each and every one of us should come to repentance. Repentance is a simply turning away from your sins. The Bible says that Nicodemus went to Jesus by night and he asked him a question. He says, what does born again mean? Born again, he wasn't talking about the physical birth, but he was talking about the spiritual birth. When we repent of our sins, we come to the Lord Jesus Christ sincerely. We ask him to forgive us for all the sinful things we've done in our bodies. Yes, we've lied. Yes, we've broken God's law. And yes, we've committed fornication. And yes, we've blasphemed the name of God. But the Bible says that Jesus paid the price on Calvary's cross for us. He shed his precious blood for the lost. Jesus says he didn't come for the righteous, but he came to save that which was lost. Jesus Christ loves each and every one of us. And I'm encouraging you today, look to Jesus. He's the savior of the world. Jesus is a healer. Jesus is a doctor. Jesus is our everything. Jesus is our advocate. And I'm encouraging all of those who believe in whatever you believe in, that Jesus died for you. And only through Jesus Christ, only through true repentance, can we have salvation. The Lord Jehovah Jireh richly bless you and keep you. And I'm just going to like close in a song, and it's called Jesus is the Answer. Hallelujah. Jesus is the answer to all the world today. Above him there's no other, and Jesus is the way. And Jesus is the answer to all the world today. Above him there's no other, and Jesus is the way. And if you have some questions in the corners of your mind, and traces of discouragement and peace you cannot find, and reflections of the old days seems to face you every day. But there's one thing I do know, that Jesus is the way. And Jesus is the answer to all the world today. Above him there's no other, and Jesus is the way. And Jesus is the answer to all the world today. Above him there's no other, and Jesus is the way. A lot of you may be going through a lot of troubles, financial troubles. A lot of you may be going through family problems. A lot of you may be even going through marital problems. But there is hope in the name of Jesus. There is peace. release in the name of Jesus. There is deliverance in the name of Jesus. We're walking about going from our daily business, but tomorrow is not guaranteed to each and every one of us. Today is a day of salvation. Don't put it off because tomorrow may be too late. I'm encouraging you in the name of Jesus. Give your life to the Lord. Repent because tomorrow may be too late. The Bible says that God is a good God. God is a mighty God. And God loves us so much that he laid down his life for you and for me. And there's no other name under heaven or the earth can a man be saved. Only by the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ loves you. Jesus Christ died for you. Jesus Christ can set you free. Jesus Christ, he cares for our souls. And that's why he died on Calvary. He took one man, Adam, to bring sin into the world. And he took another man, Jesus Christ, to redeem man back to himself. Only through the blood of Jesus. When Jesus died on the cross, he was reconciling our sins. He took them upon himself because he cares for you and he cares for me. And in the name of Jesus, remember today one thing. And I'll just close in St. John 3, verse 16 and 17. It says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, and that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him, Jesus Christ, can have life and have it more abundantly. God bless you and keep you. And the Lord's Prayer simply says, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. May the Lord Yeshua Jesus richly bless you and keep you, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.